Bienvenidos a Zona Kite, el primer programa de TV dedicado al universo del kitesurf. En Kite en primera persona, Jesse Richman nos cuenta sus sueños y el día que descubrió por qué decidió dedicar su vida al kitesurf. En Viajando con el Viento, nos vamos a Brasil mientras seguimos al equipo de F1. En InfoKite te mostramos las últimas novedades del mundo del kitesurf. En Kite School aprendemos cómo ubicar los pies cuando navegas en olas con la Duotone Kiteboarding Academy. En el clip del día te mostramos los videos más impactantes del mundo del kitesurf. Llegó la hora de entrar en la zona donde volar es posible. Esto es Zona Kite. Jesse Richman, ganador de Red Bull King of the Earth 2020, nos comparte su receta para la victoria. El equipo perfecto mezclado con el entusiasmo y el estado mental adecuado. Una inspiración para todos nosotros.
I mean, I saw King of the Air first in 2000 in Maui, and that was the first time I really saw kiteboarding and done it at an extreme level, and I was watching all of the guys go crazy and do insane tricks, and I was like, this seems really cool. And then I started kiting a year later and competed in Maui, and always, you know, I was like 12 and 13 when I was competing there, so I made it into the event and I was excited about it, but still pretty far down the ranks. And then when it came back here in Cape Town, I just knew, I was like, this is the reason I got into kiteboarding, this is what I want to do with my life. And I want to be the Red Bull King of the Air.
Your 2020 Red Bull King of the Air champion in first place is Jesse Richman!
It was a pretty special event and a pretty special year. I mean, I've always had different plans going into the King of the Air, and I won it in 2013, and since then I've kind of been chasing after the win, and I've come really, really close many times. I've been in the top five every year I've competed, and I got second twice. And this year, changing my strategy up a little bit, almost not caring as much, realizing that if I come in winning or losing, the day is gonna be awesome, it's gonna be beautiful. I have an incredible sponsor to work with, incredible trips to go on, and an amazing family here supporting me, so it doesn't really matter if I win or lose. And that gave me the confidence to give everything I have on the water and not get overtaken by stress or by anxiety in any way. So I was pretty relaxed throughout the day, and it ended up being the winning strategy.
In the final, we have three Red Bull King of the Air winners. We have Jesse Richman, we have Nick Jacobson, and we have Aaron Hadlow. What a way to end it.
Well, seeing the Orbitz debut in the King of the Air last year, everyone was pretty excited and pretty curious what was gonna happen. And with Nick and me making it to the semifinals, and then, you know, having the Orbit put me on the podium last year, I feel like was pretty exciting and a little bit of a shock for everyone. And then this year, between Mark's highest jump of the event, Nick's highest score of the event, and my win, I think this kite is starting to really create a place in the sport as the ultimate big air kite. It just really becomes one with you in the sense that I know exactly what the kite's gonna do. It's extremely predictable, even when the wind is totally crazy. And having that connection to my kite is an absolute must, especially when I need to trust so much in it. Because we put ourselves in positions where if something goes wrong, there are pretty intense consequences. So you need to really rely on your kite, and that's only formed through, you know, many hours of having that kite catch you and having that trust build. And I've gotten to the point now with the Orbit that it's the kite I want, it's a kite I need in these situations to be able to really give it 100%.
There goes Jesse. It's the first handle pass of the final.
I rode the Focus in this event, and I've been riding the Focus throughout the year because I really like the little bit of extra rocker that board has. The Atmos is an incredible big air board, and that's what the majority of the other riders were using. But I go with the Focus because it has that little bit extra rocker and really helps, especially when I'm coming down hard, which is something that I tend to do. So having that little bit extra kick helps absorb the landing a little bit better, and having the flex in that board really helps explode on the takeoffs. So it does come down to a preference thing, but the way that the Focus rides for me is pretty incredible. To me, the Focus is kind of the ultimate board that I could ask for, especially in this event. Normally I'll ride a 136, but in this event I ride a 133 because we're so overpowered. So being able to have that rocker and have that smaller board really helps control the extreme amounts of power, and it still gives me a very stable base to come down and land on. During King of the Air, we need an incredible amount of hold on our boards, and having that super close, tight, and perfect connection between us and the board is essential. With the Flex straps, it really has made a massive difference, because for me, I've found that you can really have the strap fit to the contours of your foot, so you can fine-tune and adjust the strap to be fit perfectly, and especially when you're doing maneuvers like kite loop board offs, where you need to be able to take the board off and then put it back on and have it be locked on there to land. Having a strap that fits perfectly to your foot almost feels like it has a spot, so as soon as I get my foot in and I get it to that certain place in the strap, I know it's locked on. And then another aspect that's really been cool is how it has a slim profile, but what they've done is they've inserted a triple density foam. So there's three different levels of foam, with the bottom being the hardest. So even when you're coming down super hot on some of these kite loops, you still never end up bottoming out the strap and kind of injuring your heel, which has been a thing of the past. So these straps have been pretty incredible to ride and definitely become an essential part of the quiver.
El agua es nuestro medio. Queremos estar ahí, a veces con viento, a veces sin viento. Y nuestro deporte, cada vez más, se va fusionando con otras disciplinas. La llegada del foil fue un punto de inflexión para que estas fusiones se profundicen. Ahora, podemos surfear, kitear o hacer wingfoil con una misma tabla. En esta ocasión, sigamos a Miso Fernando, Tituán Galea y Remy Quique mientras ponen a prueba la nueva colección de foils de F1 en el norte de Brasil.
Fala galera, beleza? Eu sou Fernando Miso e eu vim aqui para o Rio Grande do Norte, no Brasil. Vou encontrar com o Tituan e com o Remy para a gente gravar o material para o lançamento da nova coleção de foil da F1. Esse lugar é alucinante. Tem altas ondas, muito bom para surfar de foil. O povo te recebe super bem aqui. O foil sport tem evoluído muitas formas de se usar o hidrofoil. Tudo que você precisa é de água. Pode ser uma piscina, pode ser num lago, pode ser no mar. Você pode surfar com alça, pode surfar sem alça, pode ir de stand-up, você pode fazer downwind, você pode velejar de kite. Então tem muitas possibilidades de se usar um hidrofoil. Foil tem trazido realmente novos horizontes. Foil tem me possibilitado de conhecer muita gente legal, viajar pelo mundo, conhecer lugares diferentes, surfar ondas diferentes, com pessoas diferentes. E isso está sendo demais. É muito legal como o Foil traz uma visão, faz com que a gente tenha uma visão diferente do line-up das ondas em si, que a gente não está mais preocupado em pegar uma onda, surfar essa onda até o final e depois voltar remando para o outside. A gente pode pegar uma onda pequena, qualquer onda que vier pelo caminho, ficar em pé, depois sair dando pump para conectar com outras ondas. Isso é uma coisa que é muito legal, que faz com que você veja o mar como uma pista de skate, onde você não precisa parar, você vai direto, pegando onda atrás de onda, conectando, ou você pode até pular de uma pedra, um lugar que seja perto de onde quebra uma onda, sair dando pump até conectar numa onda e depois conectar em várias outras ondas. Isso é uma coisa muito diferente, e faz com que a gente tenha uma visão do mar que antes a gente não tinha. A gente pegava uma onda, surfava até o final e quando acabasse, acabou.
Contato, às vezes quem é surfista, assim, quem surfa, às vezes perde a prancha e às vezes você mergulha junto com a onda e você tem essa sensação de ir junto com a onda debaixo d'água. E eu percebi que isso é como fosse a mesma coisa, tipo a hidrodinâmica, né? E você mergulhando, você mergulha e você vai junto com a onda.
Você sente o vácuo da onda.
Sente o vácuo da onda. E tipo, eu já tive uma noção. Pô, foil, como é que é? Eu olhei assim, que louco. E tava vendo essas asas, é animal, tipo, bizarro.
El GKA Kite World Tour, como casi todos los eventos deportivos del planeta, se ha suspendido debido a la pandemia mundial, pero eso no significa que la diversión deba detenerse. Démosle la bienvenida al nuevo formato de competencia, de GKA Distance Battle.
We are back, bringing you the best in the business, the finest freestyle kitesurfing talent on the planet, from their home to your home. That's right, this is the GKA Distance Battles. The GKA top riders will face each other in a new online format. with heats captured at their home spots and scored by our panel of international judges from around the world, we are bringing the kitesurfing community together in a way never seen before. In these unprecedented times, this new format will allow the world's best to keep pushing the level and show us what they have been working on during this time out. Forward and how can you get involved at home? There are four fleets, twin tip and strapless freestyle, both men and women. The top six men and the top three women pre-qualify via the 2019 GK World Ranking. There will be one additional wildcard for each discipline, and this is where you come in. These wildcards are selected via public vote from our pre-selected list. After this, the competitors will get out on their home spot with the best possible forecast and capture their absolute best uninterrupted heat. This will be brought to you live in a series of online live events. Live competition, live commentary, live interviews, live scoring, combining the world's best in a way never seen before. Now it's over to you guys and girls at home. Vote for your wildcard of choice. Get the neighbors involved. Get the family involved. Hey, get the dog involved. You have until the 21st of June.
La votación para que cuatro riders compitan junto a los mejores del mundo finalizó. Y los elegidos por el público para participar en los GKA Distance Battles son: en Twin Tip Freestyle Hombres, Abdu Montowoki y Juan Rodríguez. En Twin Tip Freestyle Mujeres, Paula Novotna. En Strapless Freestyle Hombres, Kiko Roig Torres y Camille Delanoy. En Strapless Freestyle Mujeres, Mikaeli Sol.
The riders will then have 1 month to capture that perfect performance before we kick off the live shows on the 3rd of August. Let the GKA Distance Battles begin.
La posición de tus pies es muy importante cuando estás navegando en una tabla de olas. Dependiendo de dónde estén posicionados tus pies, la tabla se comportará de distintas maneras. Al mover tu pie trasero hacia el frente del pad, te ayudará para planear más rápido, virando contra el viento y para ganar velocidad. Para curvas cerradas, siempre deberás mover tu pie trasero de vuelta sobre el pad. Veamos rápidamente distintos escenarios. Cuando estés saliendo desde la playa, posiciona tu pie trasero en la dirección frontal del pad o incluso un poco por delante. La tabla se aplanará sobre el agua y te permitirá navegar con menos resistencia. De todas formas, la tabla será mucho menos maniobrable. Al caer en una ola plana, que no tiene mucho empuje, mueve tu pie trasero al frente del pad. Cuando ganes más velocidad, lleva el pie hacia atrás para poder doblar mejor. Podés mover tu pie trasero de vuelta hacia el pad antes de entrar a la ola si esta es profunda, rápida y tiene mucho empuje. En olas empinadas y rápidas, querrás mover tu pie trasero hacia adelante para volver a ganar velocidad, como por ejemplo, en este momento, para orzar alrededor de la espuma. Practica cambiar la posición de los pies primero en agua plana, ya que esto mejorará tu performance durante tu sesión en las olas. Acá van unos tips rápidos para tus primeros cambios de posición. Volá el kite un poco alto mientras cambias la posición de los pies. Esto te ayudará con el balance. Move tu peso hacia el pie frontal mientras cambias la posición de los pies. Comenzá con pequeños cambios de posición. levanta los pies un poquito y baja con los dedos de los pies primero. Finalmente, recordemos los elementos clave para cambiar la posición de los pies. Mueve tu pie trasero hacia adelante para planear más rápido virando upwind. Entrar a olas planas. Mueve tu pie trasero hacia atrás para curvas rápidas y cerradas. Disfruta de tu aventura con Duotone Kiteboarding Academy. En el clip del día, te mostramos los videos más impactantes del mundo del kitesurf.
Good morning, this is Captain Arun from MV Leapheart. Vessel is currently anchored 5 miles east of Copenhagen. We normally transport up to 28,000 metric ton of various bulk cargo worldwide. But today, the assignment is a little different. At 0730 AM, a special cargo package will board the vessel and pump up its kite on main deck. His name is Nick Jacobson, a pro kite surfer from Denmark.
Slip! Perfect!
Kite launch completed. Please proceed.
Okay.
The package must climb to the steering house of the green.
Yeah, good luck, Zappa.
Safety first, my friend.
That's what I need, Jonas.
Tell the package to start walking to the tip of the green.
Okay, sir.
Package can disembark.
Zona Kite es tu zona. Vos también sos protagonista de nuestro programa. Mándanos tus fotos y videos a zonakitetv@gmail.com para compartirlas en nuestras redes sociales. Esto es todo por hoy. Los esperamos en la próxima edición de Zona Kite.